Hello children, welcome to online class. I am Suma Poddar from Appa Public School.
I am Mrs. Jyoti Kale from Appa Public School, CBSE, Kalburgi.
Today we are here to take revision for grade 4 of science subject. So let us start the revision for first lesson, that is leaf, the food factory of plant. What is the lesson? Lesson number 1, leaf, the food factory of plant. So let us recall children what we have learned in this chapter. So we have learned so many things in this chapter, that is about the leaf. Yeah, as we know that the leaves are green in color. Why do they look green? Do you know the reason? Yes, they look green in color because they contain green pigment called chlorophyll. So this chlorophyll, it helps in the process of photosynthesis. So again we learned that about the process of photosynthesis. What is a photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is the process by which the plants prepare their own food using carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. And during this process of photosynthesis, the plants prepare the food. That food is called as glucose. What is that? That is called as glucose. And this glucose, it is stored in the plants. And they use this glucose to get the energy. And whatever extra glucose is there, the plant will store in different parts like root, stem, leaves, fruits, flowers and seeds. And also we have learned about the different parts of leaf. So have you seen the leaf, children? Yes, you can see here, this is the leaf. So this is the leaf. There are three main different parts of leaf. You can see here, this is the green exposed portion. This is the green exposed portion, is known as leaf blade. It is known as leaf blade. And here you can observe the central thick part is called as midrib. Central thick part is called as midrib. And also you can observe here, children, you can see the branches which are arising from the midrib. So here branches which are arising from the midrib, it is called as veins. So these veins help to supply water and prepare food. So the three main parts of leaf are leaf blade, midrib and veins. So these are the three main parts of leaf. And also we have learned about uses and functions of leaf. As we know, the main function of leaf is to prepare food for plants. And some of the uses of leaf are, some plants' leaves are used as medicine, like neem and tulsi. And also some plants' leaves are used as vegetable, like cabbage and spinach. So let us learn the process of photosynthesis and the parts where the food is stored in plants by using this model. So let me explain. Before starting this activity, let me explain the parts of this model. So here, children, you can see, these are the flashcards. So these are the flashcards and this is the pointer. And here you can see, this is the indicator which shows the process of photosynthesis. And this is the indicator which shows the end product of the photosynthesis process. And these here you can see, these are the slots to fix the flashcards. And here you can see, this is the indicator which shows the different part different plants store food in different parts of the plant. So let us start this activity by using this model. Children, you have learned the different parts of plant. Which are the different parts of plant? They are root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, and seed. So now let us see how this photosynthesis process works. So children, can you say me what are the raw materials needed for photosynthesis process?
Yes, the raw materials required for the process of photosynthesis are water, carbon dioxide, and sunlight. And along with that, chlorophyll is also necessary. It is already present in the leaf.
It is already present in the leaf.
So let us learn now how the plant will take all these materials for the process of photosynthesis. First, water. As we know, the plants need water to grow. The water is absorbed by the roots. Water is absorbed by the roots, and this water is supplied to all the parts of the plant. And next raw material is carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide, it is present in the atmosphere. Then how do the plants take the carbon dioxide? Yes, the leaves. The leaves help to absorb the carbon dioxide. How? The leaves have the tiny openings on the undersurface, and these openings, they help to absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. So where to place this carbon dioxide? Here. And the next raw material is the sunlight. As we know that the sun is the main source of energy. So sunlight is provided by the sun, and this sunlight is absorbed by the plants for the process of photosynthesis. And the photosynthesis, do you know children, in which part of the plant the photosynthesis carried out? Yes, the leaves, they help in the process of photosynthesis. Why? Because they already have the chlorophyll. That means the chlorophyll also one of the essential material needed for the process of photosynthesis. And as the leaves, they help in the process of photosynthesis, the leaf is called the food factory of the plant. What is the leaf called? The food factory of plant, or otherwise it is also called as kitchen of the plant. What it is? Leaf is called kitchen of the plant. So right, in this process, as we told earlier, the glucose is produced in this process, and the glucose, it is made up of the elements of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen, and it is used as a food for all living beings.
So as the process begins, so the end product is known as oxygen. So the end product of this photosynthesis process is oxygen. Here you can see the indicator which shows the oxygen produced by the plants. So the oxygen produced by the plants, which is used by all living organisms for breathing. So oxygen, which is produced by plants, it is used by all living organisms for breathing. So now let us see the extra food which is stored in different parts of the plant, how they are stored in different parts of the plant.
The extra food which is prepared by the plant, it may be stored in different parts, like it may be stored in roots or stem or leaf or flowers or fruits or seeds.
For example, see here, you can see roots. So you can see here the extra food is stored in roots. Example, beetroot and carrot. Extra food is stored in roots. Example is beetroot and carrot. Stem here. The extra food, it is stored in which part here? It is stored in the stem part. For example, potato. And also you can see here the extra food is stored in flower. Extra food is stored in flower. Example is cauliflower. So here the extra food is stored in which part here? It is stored in the leaves. For example, cabbage and spinach. And also you can see the extra food is stored in fruits like apple, mango, banana and so on. So the next, the extra food is stored in seeds like peas. So this is how the extra food which is produced during the photosynthesis process, it is stored in different parts of the plant. And this food is used by all living organisms. So we can conclude that without photosynthesis process, there is no oxygen. So if there is no photosynthesis process, then there is no food to eat and no oxygen to breathe. Thank you. And there is no life on the earth. And remember children, the photosynthesis is the unique process which is carried out in case of plants. Thank you.